Do you know, guys, what is GPU and how does it work? If you don't know, don't worry about it. We are going to discuss what is GPU, how it is different from the CPU, how does it work, and how to make artificial intelligence machine learning models without having GPU inside your system. So don't waste your time. Let's get it started. So what is GPU? GPU is a stand for the graphic processing unit. It is used for doing complex tasks that CPU cannot do with easily. NVIDIA and the AMD are the two main manufacturers of the GPU. We can understand it is a GPU is a graphical, not graphical, GPU is a hardware unit that deals with the graphical information. Graphical information means we are going to deal with the vertices and the pixels. So GPU is generally made for doing efficient calculation on graphical information, okay? So this is a GPU. And now the working of a GPU. GPU has a number of processing cores running on a slow speed. This slow speed is actually very fast because every core deals with the two functions, that is pixels and the vertices. This is how we do parallel processing by using GPU. Vertex processing is done by the coordinate system. And everyone know what is coordinate system. It is X, Y, and we can have this alternate. And in the case of 3D, we have three alternates, that is X axis, Y and Z. The GPU does geometrical calculation and reproduce dimensional space on your screen. So that's how GPU works for the vertices. Or in the case of pixels, GPU requires more computational power because pixel processing contains complex, or we can say intensive information. So this is the working of a GPU. In this slide we have a figure, and the left hand side we have a CPU, in the right hand side we have a GPU, and from the green color we have a program instruction. So deep CPUs contain less number of cores. In my figure there is only 4 cores, and the GPU has contained the more number of cores, okay? So generally GPU contains more than 100 number of cores. Suppose we have an application program having 1000 number of instruction. An instruction number from 1 to 600 can easily computed by the CPU. So that instruction will go to CPU for execution. And from the instruction number 600 to 1000 contains intensive information. And that instruction will go to the GPU, and GPU execute that instruction. And that's how a complete intensive program is executed. Intensive information means the information, the processing that uses your desktop screen for execution of any information. Suppose, let's take an example of a self-driving car project. That is a machine learning project. For doing that project, you need GPU because you are going to create a model that uses your desktop, or we can say your system screen. So in the next slide, we have the use of GPU. So in this slide, we are going to see the use of GPU. So basically GPU is used in the three fields, that is the VDI, artificial intelligence, and the HPC. VDI stands for the virtual desktop infrastructure. It is defined as the GPU are used to support high intensive graphic application. Examples: movie animation, rendering, high resolution game, CTC. And the field of artificial intelligence, two main subset of artificial intelligence is, that is machine learning and deep learning. GPU are specifically created for these two purpose. Some GPUs are created for the machine learning model. Some people are created to deal with the neural networks, or we can say deep learning models. So the machine learning model, let's take an example of the self-driving car, as I discussed in a previous slide with the help of the figure. So in this project, or we can say in this model, the output, or we can say the processing of your model is going to use your desktop screen. That's why GPU is used here. And the neural network, in the case of neural networks, we are going to write algorithm that thinks like a human brain. So this is how GPU used in artificial intelligence field. And the third one is high performance computing. Okay, so in these three mentioned fields, GPU are using. In the next slide, we get how to get GPU in your machine. So what is the reason why we use GPU with the help of cloud without installing in our system? So what is the cloud platform? So cloud is a platform where anyone can store their data and can do intensive computational work that they cannot do in their machine or in their system, because the performance of their system is not very much comparative to do machine learning and deep learning project. That's why we can go for the cloud platform. So there are the well-known cloud platform like AWS Cloud, that is Amazon Web Services, IBM Cloud that I personally use, and the GCP, that is Google Cloud Platform. So IBM and the GCP are one of the best. AWS is also best. AWS is also the best. Okay. The reason for using GPU and cloud. Every year, new generation of GPUs are coming, and we can't change GPU yearly as it will not very efficient related to cost, because it is not very cost effective, because the cost of the GPUs are not very less, it is very large. So purchasing a GPU for new generation in every year is also not cost effective. So that's why try to use GPU on cloud platform. If you have enough amount, so you can go for installing GPU in your system. And the GPU on cloud are maintained and time to time updated by the service provider. That is also the reason, because whenever new updates or new maintenance are coming, that automatically updated on the cloud platform. And when you use GPU by using that cloud platform, you will have updated GPU. That's the reason. And it is also very cost effective, and the load on your system is also reduced, because performance of your system is continuously constant, not going to down due to having GPU, because you have GPU on cloud platform. And by connecting internet, you can access cloud and access your GPU for the project works. That's why we use GPUs on cloud platform. If you want a separate video how to set up your cloud platform and how to get credentials for services in a cloud platform, I will make a separate video. If you want, just mention in comment. Okay. So in the next slide, there are five parameters. On the basis of these five parameters, we are going to differentiate between the CPU and the GPU. So first is consumption of memory. CPU consumes more memory in the comparison of GPU, because CPU deals with a lot of information. All the processing are done by the CPU. In the case of GPU, GPU only deals with the graphical information, so it takes less amount of memory. So CPU takes more amount of memory and GPU takes less amount of memory speed. As GPU deals with the less information, only graphical information, so the speed of GPU is far better than the speed of the CPU. And the third one is number of cores. CPU has less number of cores, generally 2, 4, 8 dual quad actor etc. And the fair case, in the case of GPU, it has more number of cores, generally in 100 or more than 100 number of cores in the case of GPU performance. Core having GPU is less powerful in the comparison of the core of CPU, because the core of GPUs are constructed for only deals with the graphical information. And they are not very good for dealing other information like ALU, arithmetic logical unit, and so on. While in the case of CPU, the core are more powerful, less number of core, but all the cores are more powerful. They can easily transfer their task. They can process tasks with an effective manner, and they are very strong to do all the processing of your system. So CPU core are more powerful, and the GPU core are less powerful. And the processing, CPU done on the linear processing and GPU works on the parallel processing, because every core deals with every individual pixels or the vertices. So that's how it is going to use parallel processing. It is how it is going to deal with the parallel processing. So these is all about the GPU. What is GPU? How does it work? How to get cloud platform for the GPU and so on. So if you like this video, just thumbs up and subscribe our channel. So thank you so much for watching this video. Thank you so much.